Good morning, I'm MaryEllen from the channel MaryEllen After 60, and today I'm going to be talking about skincare. I don't really get excited when I talk about skincare, but I have made a few changes in my skincare. I haven't added anything, but I've taken a few things away. At some point in the video, I'm going to put some before and after footage, and the one of them I know is from 4 years ago, comparing my skin to, I think it was the 10th of September. And I'm going to point out some changes later on in the video. But before I talk about anything else, I wanted to let you know that I eat a very healthy diet. I sleep very well and I drink plenty of water. I really do take care of myself. My skin is still normal. It's neither oily nor dry. And as of yet, I don't have any brown age spots. But today I am 66 and tomorrow I will be 67. So I don't know when those will come. So my skincare does not consist of products that deal with age spots, with the brown spots. So Jim and I have basically been in since March 11th. We don't go out to eat, we stay at home, and I thought it was a good time for me to experiment with the skincare that I was using. I cannot tell you how many companies want to send me their products, and I think that's really a good thing, but I've only tried a few products from one company in the last couple of years. I just want to make my skincare as simple as I possibly can and to be as effective as it can without having any type of procedures or spa treatments or anything like that. The only thing I use that is medical grade is Retin A, and that's the only product that I really go by the claims. My skin likes Retin A. I know some people it doesn't. The rest of the products I use are trial and error, and I am my own guinea pig. Before I go on, I'm going to link some videos below that I think are kind of important, especially if you're new into skincare, Tretinoin, Retin A. I've had so many people comment and say, I wish I would have watched this before I started my skincare, because it is a gradual journey. You don't ever want to start skincare where somebody already is. Because I've been using Retin A now for over 6 years, so I had to gradually work my way up to that point. I do realize everything that I do is temporary. Retin A, derma rolling, if I quit doing those things, I don't think I would lose the progress I made, but it would just start naturally wrinkling and sagging more than it already is. And in my head, I think I would start seeing the difference in 3 or 4 months in my skin if I quit using Retin A. And one of these days I might, but I'm just not ready to do that yet. I am not an authority on anything. The only thing I am an authority on is how my skin reacts to all different things. And I do know my skin and I examine it every day. Toward the end of March, I just started looking at every product I used. And I want to use the least amount of products with the most maximum benefits is what I want to do. I'm a slacker, you know that. There were two products I was not willing to give up in the morning, and it is my It Miracle Water. I opened this on September 5th, 2019. It's already been 13 months and I still have that much left. I use this after I just cleanse my face with a washcloth, a cheap, nubby washcloth. And then I go into my dressing room and I put this on a 1/4 of a Shiseido pad. So I do this every day. And consistency is a key. But this is one thing that I do every single day. And I knew I did not want to quit using the Skin Diva, the 20% Argireline with Matrixyl 3000. This is the one I use one drop a day, and I just use it here, here, and in here. And I opened this one on March 15th, 2020, so I've got a whole lot left. Using one drop a day, it does last a long time. So those were the only two products that I was going to not test. And when I removed something, I continued using everything else. I jotted everything down in a little calendar because I wanted to make notations. On April 1st, I decided I was going to continue doing my skincare the way I'm doing it. And I will put a link to that video. I'll put it up here and I'll put it below, because there's no need for me to go over everything I do. If you're interested in my skincare, I'll leave that link below and I'll put a card above. And I will buy, there's two brands I will buy for vitamin C, and that's the Timeless, and this is a pump. This one is empty, and I like it really well. It's the only thing I use every day that I keep in the refrigerator. And I also have the one from Skin Diva, and I'm going to put in front of me, I'm going to put the ingredients. They are identical. And what I do is I just cut the box off and put a little tape around it and set this in my refrigerator. And when I'm using this, when I take it out, I open it up, and that way I don't spill it. I keep it in here. But I will tell you, after, let's see, from the 1st to the 16th of April, I didn't use any on the left side of my face, and this spot right here got darker. I could tell my skin didn't look as, it did not look as youthful, it didn't glow, and I believe it helps with my exfoliation. And today I have on absolutely no makeup. I have on lipstick, mascara, and navy eyeliner. I don't even have my skincare on because it's a bright sunny day and I wanted you to see my skin as clearly as I can show it to you. So I knew that I wanted to continue with the Timeless Vitamin C. So my next step was to try something on my right side. So on April 19th, I quit using the Bye Bye Under Eye Eye Brightening Cream. And this one I opened on March 25th. And I love this. And within 1 week, I knew I wanted to go back to using this. My eyes didn't look as bright. Well, my eye didn't look as bright. This eye looked good because I was putting it on every day. And something I've really been trying to do is make sure I put it up in here. And I only use this underneath my eye. I don't put it on my lid. But within a week, I knew I needed this. So this one is staying. Now, during my nighttime routine, there were two things that I wasn't willing to do without. And one of them is the Timeless Hydrating Eye Cream. I've used this, I think it'll be 5 years next April, that I've used this every single night. I used to use it in the morning. But after I do my Retin A, I'll go in and I'll put this all underneath my eyes, on my eyelids. And it just works really, really well for me. This I opened on July 11th, 2020, and I always get 6 months because I only use about a half of a pump. I use a very small amount, so I didn't want to do without that. And last February, when I was doing my skincare update, I had added the IT Cosmetics Confidence in an Eye Cream, and I was thinking back then, I thought, I'm going to be trying this to see because, you know, I am getting older all the time, and I thought, and I'm somebody that does believe in eye cream. Just based on my experience. Yeah, maybe I could put it all over my face, but I'm not going to do that. But I quit using this on May 3rd, and I did it on my left eye, and I didn't use it for 3 weeks, and it wasn't doing anything for me. I don't have a lot of it left, so I'm going to finish this up, but I'm not going to be repurchasing anymore. The thing that's interesting, I haven't liked any of the IT Confidence in an eye cream, in a neck cream, in a moisturizer. The only thing I ever liked from the Confidence line was their Confidence in a compact. It was like a cream foundation. But those products just never did do anything for me. But I was really hopeful for this. So I haven't added another cream over this yet. As the winter approaches, I may use my secret sauce. I may use the Bye Bye Under Eye Eye Brightening Cream, but I'm just kind of good for right now. On June 7th, I quit using the IT Bye Bye Line Serum, and I quit using it on the right side of my face. And I use this in the morning. What I did instead, I used the Dermatology Tinted Moisturizer. I use this on my left side of my face. And after 3 weeks, I could see no difference. I haven't been using the Benigma. It's outside in my refrigerator. I have an unopened jar. But this tinted moisturizer from Dermatology really has, it's kept it looking the same. This is a whole lot more expensive than this is. So I quit using this. I'm going to use it on my neck. I'm going to use it other places. I'm not going to waste it. But I really do like the Dermatology. And I opened this on June 20th. I really think it's a good product. It's good to wear under makeup. It's good to just use as a tinted moisturizer. I never use the amount recommended, but I protect my face in other ways. I wear a hat. I wear glasses. I wear other sunscreen. But in July, I decided that I was going to, in the morning, I wasn't going to use hyaluronic acid. And that lasted about 3 days because my skin really likes hyaluronic acid. And then I decided I wasn't even going to try not using the Matrixyl 3000. I used both of those from Timeless. I just used this old bottle, washed it out, cleaned it, and put half hyaluronic acid and half Matrixyl 3000, and it has worked great for me. Because what I did, I'd usually put my Matrixyl 3000 or either one, it didn't really matter to me which one I put first, but I would immediately go in with the other. So I haven't seen any difference, but my skin does like this. So I was okay with what I was using. I'd pared it down some. So one day I went to use my ordinary AHA 30, BHA 2%. I have never used more than this much for an application. It's after I cleanse my face and my face is really dry. Every other Sunday I would use this, and I put on a very sheer coat and it literally burned my face. So I'd used it for several years. It never bothered me, but I had a burn here that actually scabbed. So I know that my skin doesn't like it anymore. So what I'm doing for exfoliation, I'm not using glycolic acids. I'm not using AHAs, BHAs. I'm counting on shaving my face every other day, using my nubby washcloths in the mornings, the Retin A that I use. I think all those things exfoliate my face, but I still use an enzymatic peel, a fruit enzyme peel. And I will list some below that I've used. Right now I have one, it's a Oriental, and it is a fruits peeling jelly. I have been so pleased with those, and they're so gentle. They just slough off any dead skin, and then plus by shaving every other week, it keeps the dead skin at bay. And my preference for a razor, I don't buy any big expensive kind. I use the Shiseido. I like the way that it is angled, and it never has cut me. I've had others that have cut me. And I think I usually get about two or three uses of this. When I'm done, I clean it with an alcohol pad, and I kind of like they used to do with knives, you know, I do it on a piece of denim, and it works fine. So I usually get two to three uses of this. So there are three products that I will no longer be using.
The video I filmed today and the insert of the videos and also the photos were all done in natural light. This photo was taken in July 2014 before I started Retin A. I was wearing foundation and lipstick, but I had on no eyeliner. So this is my before picture I usually consider when I compare other photos in the future. On this second picture, this is a 6-year comparison. The biggest difference I see is the increased amount of eyelid space. My eyes are not nearly as hooded. And the only thing I can really contribute this to is using Retin A, because I really haven't done anything else. On this comparison photo, the one on your left was taken 4 years ago, and it was 2 years after I began using Retin A. The biggest difference I can see is the brown round scar. It's on my upper right cheekbone below my eye. It is so much darker than it is now. And I attribute this to Retin A and the vitamin C plus E plus ferulic acid. That spot is definitely lighter. And in the last photo, even though I am 15 pounds lighter, in my recent photo on your right, my under eye wrinkles are much better now than they were 4 years ago. I do not apply Retin A close to my eyes, but I really do think my eye cream has been very beneficial. And along with that, you know, drinking plenty of water, eating well, and protecting your face from the sun.
I haven't added any products, but I have increased my dermarolling. So on September 13th, that's why I did the picture here, because I wanted to keep that and compare it to see how it does later, is when I started using the dermaroller all over my face. Prior to this, I just had used it here, eyebrows, lips, and so, but I'm doing it full force. And what I do, I set my timer for 5 minutes. It seems like I can get through all the places in about 3, and then I just go down and across, I don't try to do it every which way. I just know I'm getting little tiny holes in my skin, and we'll just see what that looks like. We'll see what that turns out. The first Sunday of the month, I use the 0.5 millimeter, and the rest of the Sundays, I do the 0.25. I buy mine from Skin Diva. Jen Amber does have good, hers are very good. They're very similar to this. They're just usually more expensive. I can get 20% off, but I really do prefer the real needles. And I'll put a picture here of real needles versus disc. And these are real needles. And if you're still here, this is going to be a giveaway. And I contacted Timeless and I contacted Skin Diva. And Timeless is going to give away two gift boxes. It's going to have the vitamin C plus E plus ferulic acid. It has the hyaluronic acid, Matrixyl 3000, hydrating eye cream, and the squalane. So that's going to be given to two people. And Skin Diva is giving away a derma roller of your choice, either the 0.25 or the 0.5. They're Matrixyl 3000 and their vitamin C plus E plus ferulic acid. So I'm going to have three winners. And in order to be in this giveaway, you just need to be subscribed to my channel before this video goes live. Be 18 years old or older. This is open internationally. In the comment section, you just need to say either Timeless or Skin Diva. And I'll put their names up here. And just whatever you want, put that first. And because this is a giveaway, I cannot answer any questions. I can't leave comments, but go to any video that I've done before and you know I'll get back to you. This will be, I'll close it in 3 days and the winners will be announced in my very next video. And that'll either be next Sunday or the next Sunday. I think I'm going to be doing every other week for a while. It is all good. I want to thank you for hanging in there with me. It's been an interesting time. I will see you in my next video, and you all take care. And today, I'm going to be I haven't added any products, but I have. So the first